Well, I started out down a dirty road. Started out all alone.
Hello, my name is Orif McMahon. I'm the chairperson of the Civic Advocacy Group from Kilrush. Dangerous place to cross the road. We want to highlight this. We're making a radio program about it. We're talking to town councillors and honorary people who cross this road. This film is about the making of the radio program. How dangerous is to cross the road?
Oh, I know myself because I come out every morning from home and I know this road is a deadly dangerous road to cross because I was living up there before and that's why I moved down to where I am. You have to look up and down when you're crossing the road and all cars are doing is flying ahead of you, flying, and they don't give people a chance to cross. And I mean, like, it's like something has to be done about it. And I feel myself, well, we should be brought back to the copper race about it.
How dangerous is this road?
This road is very dangerous, Tony. It's very difficult to cross and the traffic is coming so many different ways and people don't use the roundabout properly. So the whole way up the Kilkee Road, if you live in Nagel's Terrace, it's very difficult to cross further up. It's difficult all the time.
Do you cross this road often?
I do indeed, and it's very dangerous. I have this little fella here with me, and this one in the pram. And apart from that, it's very awkward and dangerous for adults. And there's traffic coming from all directions, down from the Coraclare Road, the Dunbeg Road, Kilkee Road, and it's awful dangerous. I've approached the authorities about it on numerous occasions, but just to no avail. We've got no results.
But there's no zebra crossing there. You should have a zebra crossing for the crossing the road. And there's children coming out from school as well.
You know, at particular times, the road is very busy here. And it's quite hard to get across. And of course, sometimes I'm breaking the rules of the road in order to get across because I'm weaving in and out through traffic.
How dangerous is this road?
Well, I'd say on a scale of 1 to 10, it's 8 or 9. It's very dangerous, particularly at peak hours, school times. It's very dangerous.
Well, without the lollipop lady, it would be very dangerous. Because the fact that it is a roundabout, you know, and everything has to stay moving. But it would be quite dangerous because you've got cars parked collecting children as well.
I live here on this street, so I cross it every day, quite a number of times.
How dangerous is it?
It's quite dangerous at times. My daughter goes to school at the Gael Skull, which is just here at the corner. And it's quite dangerous, especially on her way home. Now, she has the lollipop lady to help her, but sometimes she goes to the shop, and it's a constant worry when she has to cross.
The children cross here every morning and every evening, and it's very dangerous because the cars fly down there a lot. I wouldn't dream of crossing if the lollipop lady wasn't there, because it just would be too dangerous. I'd be afraid of my life, people would get killed. They pay no attention to the roundabout, they just fly past the roundabout there. It's very dangerous. I think there should be traffic lights there or something, some way of slowing the traffic down here, because it's deadly dangerous when children or adults are trying to cross.
And I'm frightened of the cars. I'm very frightened of the cars. And I'm afraid to go crossing the cars. It's very dangerous. They're speeding. I don't understand for a person to go across the street or nothing.
Did you tell anyone about this
person? I talked to Town Hall, but they had nothing about it. The Town Hall thought there's nothing about it, which is very dangerous anyway for all people.
Because I generally make my way down to the zebra crossing down there, which can take me out of my way, really. But if I live up that way, And if I want to, I always have to cross that way and come up this way because of the roundabout and the traffic coming from 1, 2, 3, 4 different directions. Look at it today. Just look at it. There's traffic coming from every direction.
Started out down a dirty road. Started out all alone.
Road safety is very much on my agenda as my colleagues. I think we've done a lot in the last, since I've been in it, 4 years for road safety. I think there's a lot more to do. I think sometimes our hands are tied because we actually have a national route going within the town, and if we want to do anything on that road, we have to get the permission of the NRA, the National Roads Authority. We have to get their permission, and I think that if we can get a pedestrian crossing in there where Fahy Road is, just above the youth centre, somewhere between there and the corner, if we could get a full-time pedestrian crossing in there, it would be most welcome.
Tell us about the roundabout.
Yeah, it seems we have a quite a dangerous situation in town. Unfortunately, it's a national road, so we have been fighting for quite some time to get a pedestrian crossing for you and for everybody in the town, because it is quite a danger with speeding. The cars are speeding and it's very, very hard to get across. So we as a council are communicating with the NRA in order to get that, to facilitate safe access through the town. And we are all about safety. We have pedestrian crossings dotted up and down the town for safe crossing. And unfortunately, this is one, because it's a national road, it's not happening as quickly as we would like.
Consultation is vital, and from the point of view of the town council, I think our continued consultation and liaison with groups such as the Birds of Charity, I think is vitally important.
I always felt that inclusion was very important for every sector of society. So working within, having the Birds of Charity's involvement with the town council was very important.
How positive is that then?
It has to be very positive from every angle. It's positive from the people in the Birds of Charity to give them a sense of identity and a sense of independence, that they can come along to any forum, be it a statutory meeting or even meetings like today, where we can sit down across the table and have a good open discussion. That has to be good.
We're in a time, unfortunately now, of significant financial impediments for a local authority, but I do realise the importance of providing facilities such as pedestrian crossings, and certainly the issues that were raised by the Brothers of Charity going back to our meeting in last March have been, I suppose, we have looked at those and we have tried to deal with as many of the matters as we can.
It's not that councils or our government agencies are inaccessible. People feel they're inaccessible. And I do think that people need to realise that these services are actually there for them. They're actually there for ye. We are here for ye. We're not here for our own self. And that you should find yourself able to approach your local representatives and get what you want.
I'm learning to fly, but I ain't got wings. Coming down is the hardest thing. Well, the good old days may not return, and the rocks might melt, and the seed may burn. I'm learning to fly, but I ain't got wings. Coming down.
You're listening to Radio Kirkabaskin on 94.8 FM. It's Kilrush Safe Town for People Crossing the Road, or Our Cars All That Matter. In this show, we will be looking at the problems
people experience daily when crossing the road in Kilrush. We will be talking to Town Councillors, the Town Clerk and ordinary citizens who feel ignored when it comes to their safety. People with disabilities are one of the most vulnerable when it comes to crossing the road. Our reporters, Orla McMahon, Kathleen Ryan and Donnie Dillon, have been out and about and have prepared this report for us.
Radio, and particularly working with people through the Brothers of Charity, is a great way to highlight issues that mainstream media choose to ignore or are not interested in. And because we're free from commercial pressures, we don't have to rely on advertising to keep us open, to keep us running, then we can explore different things. I guess content that I need for the station, and you get something, you know, a sense of purpose.
Yeah.
And get to express yourself.
Yeah.
So it's, you know, it's great. It's very important.
Yeah. Next, we'll listen to a piece of music.
To be seeing anybody get hurt on the road, or I don't want to see crashes on the road, or I don't want to see kids or people knocked down on the road, and that's the way I feel about it.
And it just needs a simple pedestrian crossing, and it's a pity. I hope it's done before somebody is killed or hurt or seriously injured anyone.
There's definitely a need for something. I know that my wife was actually nearly knocked down at the roundabout some time ago.
You should never hesitate to approach your local councillors if there's ever anything that you want. That's what we're there for, is that you have a problem, you approach your local councillors. Yes. And you pester them till you get what you want. So it's very important that you do speak up.
Yeah.
Because you won't get anything if you don't ask.
That's true. Yeah.